Okay, so I made a dry test to see how the veneer is laying on the shape, and as you can see on this area here, it's like a little bit folded and it doesn't really want to attach to the shape. So I think I need to make this a little bit further out, so I'm gonna change the mold a little bit. But yeah, on the other side it's very nice. Alright, so here we are, second try, and I've put a little bit more material here, and as you can see now, it's like not folding away anymore, so it's kind of very tight to the mold everywhere. Also on the bottom side. Okay, now I have finally fixed up the mold and put on some foil over there, so I don't have any glue residue or stick the wood to the mold. And yeah, I'm just gonna use regular tight bond glue, wood glue for this, and I hope it works, because it's always, you don't have so much time because the glue is getting dry and starting to cure quite fast. Fine. Just press this one in. Okay, everything looks really good. Fits nice to the mold. It's nice and tight. On the back. And the good thing about the vacuum is that it cures faster than it would normally do. But we'll wait at least like half an hour to an hour and see how it's developing. So the two sides are ready or dried, and yeah, the first one worked quite well. I already sanded it really nicely, didn't have many problems with this one, but on this one you might see this bird's eye maple, it's quite, quite rough, and it really folded up here, and I couldn't get like the pressure on it. Maybe my pump is too weak or anything, but I need to flatten that, and I'm gonna try to do that now on the mold. And as you can see, didn't glue here, but I took put enough glue on there, so there should be some glue underneath the veneer. And what I'm gonna do is to make it wet and use a hot iron and try to push it down, and maybe that works. it works, but yeah, it takes quite a while. So the glue underneath needs to first dissolve, so the water and heat will make it sticky again and liquid. And then I need to kind of run the iron over it until it's completely dried and push it down. I would imagine if you use like solid material of this kind, it's even harder, kind of to bend it the traditional way. So I just put it on here and kind of mark the line, and yeah, it's quite close, but I think it will be enough. The hole. I'm going to mark the inside. And the outside line, so because it's not totally flat, kinda have to sign it off and then fit it in and round the edges. Now I'm gonna make the round edges and then glue it in.
So I think probably using an epoxy or something else that doesn't contain water might be better, because the veneer doesn't curl like that. Yeah, I need to help a little so all the air gets out and we got pressure everywhere. Thank you.
So it's really hard to get it around the corner here. And I already made the cuts much closer, so it bends more, but I think I need to just sand off here, and that will make it bend all the way. So now it bends all the way. Okay, now as the glue of these curvings is frying, I'm gonna use my little pieces of leftover curvings. So it's always some left. Sometimes they crack and yeah. So I got a lot of these, and I'm gonna use them to make the bottom side, because it's going around like up and down, and I can't use like in one piece, because it's going up and down. So, and for this I'm gonna use this time some height glue. And the nice thing about height glue is that you don't need like clamping pressure. So just put it on there and wait a couple of seconds, and then it kind of sucks itself to the piece. Just putting it on there and waiting a couple of seconds. It should stick. And also all this grease out will be quite easy to clean, so it stays in this gel-like state for quite a while. had to add a little bit of wood here, because I cut off the block in that shape, but because it's going up here, yeah, you need it. I need to add like at least a centimeter, and also on the back block it was a little bit too low, but yeah, I'm gonna cut it roughly with the saw now, so because it's going up. I see that it fits quite well at some places, and yeah, not so well on others. And yeah, it's too early to sand it with the mold. I think I'll have to use some more drastic measures to yeah, get rid of some material here. Okay, I've clamped on the back now, roughly, and I've noticed that I have like some problem areas where I, yeah, because I kind of slipped with the drum sander, and it's quite fast to get off too much. So yeah, there's like an area, and I was very concerned about here, but as you can see, pretty much you can kind of, yeah, press it on there. So yeah, it's not totally necessary to have like the exact same shape like this one. It's more important that I have like a even line, like not a hump like this. So more or less just make sure that the line is quite flows quite nicely. So I'm using the trick with the pencil again. So you kind of run it along the edge, and because it's quite thick, yeah, you get like the line where you need to sand to. So I've changed my strategy. I'm gonna use now the back actually to sand the sides. So I put some sandpaper on there with double-sided tape and clamped the frame to the bench.
I'm gonna use that now to sand the sides. Time to glue on the back, and I will use some tape to fix it first. So I've got a problem that I have to push these shoulders a little bit in. Gonna use the tape for that, and then I'm gonna use some clamps to get like enough pressure on here. And I got these rubber bands I cut from bicycle tires, and I'm gonna wrap it and use some clamps too as well. And yeah, let's see how that goes. worried a little bit that these bands are gonna push it in too much. So let's see. It's already started to cure. Better. Try again. Alright, I'm gonna leave it like that. If I had a spray can, I could make a Van Halen paint job. But yeah, I think it's gonna do it, and I wait until tomorrow. So I made myself a so-called Grammel, and I can use it to guide this knife and make a cut for the binding. I simply push it against the side, and the blade cuts always at the same length. Then I can flip it and also cut this side. Like this. And then I can insert the binding. Thank you.
So making the binding will be quite a challenge because it's not only bent in this direction like normally, it's also going up and down. And what I'm trying to do is make that out of strips of vinyl and then glue it onto the body in a semi-dried state, so when it's still like flexible, and then I hope I can kind of bend it in this way too. So I'm just going to use this my mold, and I put some plastic on there so it doesn't stick to the body, and then I'm gonna apply these veneers on there and dry it. Okay, so I have taped out the back and side, so I don't get any glue on that I have to clean up later. Now I'm gonna apply the tag bond, and again use the rubber bands to clamp it. Thank you.
Okay, so there you have it, that's the finished body, and because you made it to the end, I'm gonna oil it now, and I can oil it because I'm gonna use French polish later on, and yeah, I can oil it right now, doesn't matter when I do it, protect it a little bit. Show you the nice grain. Alright, so thanks for watching and see you next time.